Think of what you know. Great kings and prophets looked forward to the coming of God's Son and saw it dimly. You are in the age that has seen him come and know him. Great kings and prophets like David approached God in that old tabernacle, and the best they could do is to stand outside and look to a God who remained distant, hidden behind the curtain of the veil. Had you said to King David, "King David, your majesty, that was a delightful number that you wrote the other day. You know, we've got it. In fact, it's most popular with us nowadays. We have it on in our house all the time. You know, that number you wrote about forgiveness. Blessed is the man whose sins are forgiven, whose iniquity is covered." It goes to our hearts, David. We were thinking, David, suppose you were in his palace in all those centuries ago. We were thinking, David, what if you got your harp and came along with us and we went into the holiest of all in the temple and had a praise session together and sang your psalm? David would have gone white round the cheeks. Enter the holiest of all? Of course not. You can't come into the holiest of all. And the great King David had to stand outside. Blessed are your eyes, says Christ, for the things that you see, and your ears for the things that you hear, things that prophets and kings never saw or heard. For you live in the age when the Son of God is come, and the true light now shines. And you are admitted into the very holiest of all of God's family and heart.